Hey guys, this is Neil Davis from Digital Cloud Training. I recently sat the AWS SysOps beta exam. There's a new version of the SysOps Administrator exam coming soon. The code name is SOA-C02. So it's just an update of the SOA-C01. Now there is one major change. The big change is that AWS have now introduced exam labs. So that means that in addition to the multi-choice question section, you then have an exam lab section at the end where you have to actually go hands-on into the AWS management console and actually follow some scenarios and complete some configurations. So that's a new element. AWS have never done it before. Many other vendors do that, but AWS are doing it for the first time with the SysOps exam. Now, I suspect that they're going to do it with other exams in the future too. And it's a good thing because what they want to do is have people who actually prove that they have hands-on knowledge, not just the ability to answer questions. Because when you go into a job environment, just having some theoretical knowledge isn't enough. You need to be able to actually get hands-on, which is why I concentrate so heavily on hands-on in my courses. So a little bit about the exam. The beta exam runs from February the 16th to March the 26th, 2021. Now, the older version of the exam, the current exam, is available throughout that period. And it's also available after that period. It's not until Q3 2021 when the final version of the SOA-C02 will be released. So between now and then, you can carry on as normal, study the way you have been, and pass the exam until Q3. And then you'll have to do the new exam with the exam labs component as well. Now, from a certification perspective, if you earn a certification now with the existing exam, or you earn a certification on the new exam, it doesn't make any difference. The certificate doesn't tell you the version of the exam, and they're all valid for 3 years anyway. So it really doesn't make any difference. I recommend people stick with the current exam for now until the new exam is released and then start taking the new exam. So for a bit of feedback about the exam, there's obviously two components. You've got the multi-choice section where you're just answering questions and then the exam lab section. So the multi-choice section surprised me a little bit because the first probably 7 or 8 questions I got, I recognized the minute I saw them. They were basically the same questions as I'm used to in the existing version of the exam. I often expect that AWS are going to give a completely new pool of questions, but they don't. So some of the questions were exactly the same. Now, maybe there were slight differences. I couldn't tell. They looked the same to me anyway. Now, there were, of course, some new questions as well. I would say that there were probably at least 20 odd questions in the 55 questions I received that I recognized. The rest were new questions. Now, the theme of those questions is the same. So there were a couple of topics that went into a little bit more depth. Amazon Athena, Amazon Elasticsearch, quite a few questions on that one. But otherwise, it was very much the same sort of questions that you're seeing in the existing version of the exam, just new questions, asking you to answer questions about existing subjects, the ones that you should already know if you're studying for the exam today. I'd say the overall difficulty was not harder, I would say it was lower. Now, I think that AWS are trying to make sure they separate the foundational, the associate, and the professional levels, so the questions are very distinct in terms of difficulty. And it seems to me, at least, that that's something that they're endeavoring to do. The professional level questions are always a lot longer, a bit more complex. They involve more services working together. The associate level questions go certainly into quite a bit more depth than the foundational, but they're not too difficult. They're fairly short. The question length is fairly short. The answer length is fairly short, with just a few longer questions thrown here and there in the exam. So I wouldn't worry about the difficulty of the questions. I think they're very much on par. The topics are very similar. So other than a few tips that I've got in terms of things like Elasticsearch that you definitely need to know a bit more about the topology of Elasticsearch and how you can use it in hybrid environments and that kind of thing. But otherwise, it's very much the same topics that are already in my courses today. Now, what about the exam labs? So after you've done your 55 questions, you then move on to exam labs. Now, the overall length of the beta exam is 225 minutes. And they recommend that you have about an hour towards the end in order to have 20 minutes per exam lab scenario. Now, I had a lot more than that. I went very fast through the questions. But 20 minutes per exam lab should be more than adequate. I thought the overall difficulty of the exam labs wasn't that hard. What happens is after you finish the multiple choice question section, You have to agree that you're finalizing the questions. You can't go back and edit them. Then you move into the exam labs. You get a Windows 7 desktop. You just press to log in. And then you have an AWS management console. And through the console, you then have to create some kind of configuration. On the right-hand side of the screen, this side for you, there's some instructions. So you just have to follow those instructions and create the configuration. It wasn't that hard. They were fairly easy. The only problem I had was one of the services, the very first exam lab, was AWS config. And it was throwing up errors saying that it was experiencing extremely high demand. Try again later. And I actually couldn't save my configuration. I tried several times, and eventually I just gave up on it and moved on. I could have probably asked a proctor for some help there, but really I'm just having a look at the new exam format. I've already passed the exam very recently. So I moved on. The other two went very well. I thought they were fairly straightforward. If you're doing a course that's got hands-on lessons in it, you'll be fine. I certainly cover hands-on for all of the services that were included in the exam labs within my courses. So if you're doing my course, you'll be absolutely fine. So that's about it for the feedback. Obviously, I can't go into any more depth on exactly what I saw. I don't want to compromise the exam. And of course, we have to sign an agreement at the beginning that we don't share too much. So I just wanted to give you an overall idea of what to expect, because the eventual exam, the one that's released in Q3, is probably going to be very similar in terms of the number of questions and the exam labs. So I wanted to give you an idea of what to expect when that happens. I think the overall testing experience is obviously a little bit harder just because you have those two components. You have the questions, not that they were more difficult, but then you have that extra time that you've got to concentrate to do the exam labs as well. So the overall experience is a longer exam, but not particularly difficult. Any one component of it is not too hard. So I hope that was useful to you. And by the way, there is a blog article which is linked in the description for the video. So if you like to read, then you can go and read very much what I've just been telling you in the blog article. So that's it for now. See you next time.